How cute is this pendant? I just found it while like clearing my cupboard, and it's like from Shein. So back in the day when we could shop from Shein, but so cute. Also, by the title of this video, you all might think that it's a controversial video, but hear me out, okay? Watch it till the end to really know what I'm trying to say in this video, and then make your point in the comments, okay? Fine. Now let's dive into this. Hi you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. For today's video, we are reviewing. Finally, we are reviewing the Be Minimalist Peeling Solution. So this brand did create a lot of controversy when it came on the market itself, and everybody had their questions up that is it really as good as The Ordinary? Now, The Ordinary is a skincare company based in the UK and it has been there for years now, and they make skincare products very like clean, safe. They just are very transparent about the ingredients that they use, and they use very active chemical formulations, so they have always had like very potent active ingredients in their skincare. So the Be Minimalist skincare company was also based on similar lines. Their main tagline of their skincare is a transparent beauty, so they are supposed to like reveal everything that they are putting in their skincare and all of that. So today we are reviewing the AHA BHA peeling solution from Be Minimalist, and we are going to compare it to The Ordinary peeling solution. I have both of them here with me. I'm going to give you a review, demo, as well as do side by side compare ingredients. And also, we are going to talk a little bit about how I feel of this entire controversy. So if you're interested to know all of that, then you can continue watching. But before that, if you're new to my channel, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. And if you're new here and you've not subscribed to my channel, or you watch my videos and you've not subscribed to my channel, then please make sure that you do. I try to keep my content very honest and super inclusive. So I'm sure you'll have a great time if you're into that sort of content. So hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon right next to it, and then let's dive into today's video. Okay, first things first, I'm just going to raise these two bottles right here side by side and show you all what a complete copy this was of The Ordinary. Okay, so this is the original The Ordinary skincare product. This is their AHA BHA peeling solution, and this is the Minimalist AHA BHA peeling solution. This is their original packaging. Of course, everyone on the internet called them out, but later on they put up a post on their Instagram saying that they were in a rush, and due to the COVID they had another packaging in mind, but because they had to rush their launch, they came out with this packaging. Okay, fair enough. When they gave that explanation, it was a very solid explanation. We all bought it. I bought it as well, and then I was like, you know what, let's not share them any further. Let's see what they have. So I went ahead and bought this bottle myself with my own money. This is not a sponsored video. I have nothing against the brand as well whatsoever. I have no association with the brand, so whatever I'm going to say is my honest opinion as always. Now what I have right here is their original packaging. Literally within 20 days time, not even that, less than that, I think they went ahead and changed their packaging, and now they have a brand new bottle. I'm going to put up the photo right here. So this brand new bottle and all of their bottles and the packaging has changed. So if they could do this, my first question is, if they could do this in literally 20 days or less than 20 days after the launch, why didn't you do it in the first place and delay your launch by literally 15 to 20 days? I mean, hello, like this is cheap marketing right there, right? Because you created a controversy, everybody bought your product to see is it really like The Ordinary or what is it, or so many creators must have bought it like me to review it for their channels, and then you went ahead and changed your packaging. So but anyway, keeping that also aside, initially when they came out with this product, that is the AHA BHA peeling solution. Now this is a chemical exfoliant. If you have no idea what a chemical exfoliator is, how you're supposed to use it and all of that, I have a complete chemical exfoliation 101 video on my channel, so I'm going to link it on top over here for you. So after you're done watching this video, you can also go have a look at that video, so you get an idea about what you're supposed to use on your skin according to your age and according to your skin type and everything. Anyway, now this particular product is supposed to have AHA 30%, BHA 2%, copying the exact name from The Ordinary's peeling solution, which is AHA 30% and 2% BHA. Now with the new packaging, they have come up with this product doesn't even exist anymore. The same product, they have labeled it as 25% AHA, 5% PHA and 2% BHA. Now I know that PHAs and AHAs are very similar in action, but they are not the same thing. So, you being transparent beauty, why didn't you really be transparent about this on your initial packaging? That means you were literally just trying to copy The Ordinary's names and everything and tell people that, oh my god, yes, we are the dupe of Ordinary. Whoever's now buying the bottle has a different transparency on their packaging, and whoever first bought it has a different transparency on their packaging. So again, a little bit of shade, sensing a little shade right there. Anyway, let's keep that also aside. Another thing that really, really bothered me about the packaging, and I know I'm going much into the intricacies of the packaging because you guys, this is a chemical exfoliator. Everything that comes with the packaging is very important because a person who has no idea what chemical exfoliation is, who has no idea how they're supposed to use it, will refer to the cardboard packaging, the unicarton of the product for their entire information on how they're supposed to use it. And the main thing that bothered me about this product, in general about the packaging and the product itself, is because on the packaging, on the unicarton as well as on the bottle, this states that it's a weekend exfoliating facial. And oh my god, you guys, please don't use it every weekend if you have it. Do not make that mistake. 30% AHA and 2% BHA is very, very strong for your skin. It's a very strong exfoliant. If you watched my video with Dr. Anish Sheth, he's also mentioned this in his video that Indian skin has a very sensitive barrier. We are not supposed to be using such strong chemical exfoliants on a weekly basis. If you have something like this, even the ordinary one for that matter, you're supposed to use it on a monthly basis. So the main thing that I wanted to point out about this product, that it claims so loudly that it's a weekend exfoliating facial, whereas the ordinary says it's a 10 minute exfoliating facial. Both of these are only supposed to be kept on your skin for 10 minutes and then supposed to be washed off. But this claims that it can be used every weekend, but I highly, highly recommend that you do not do that. Please don't put your skin through that. It's not good for your skin's barrier. Worst comes to worst, they say weekly facial and also weekend facial, and in the directions they say that after you increase it to twice per week if your skin can tolerate it. Bapre, I can't even imagine if you what will happen if you use it twice per week. Don't do that, you guys. Please don't go by the instructions on this bottle and on their website. If Be Minimalist is watching or anybody from their team is watching, please change the name to a 10 minute exfoliating facial or just an exfoliating facial. Okay, one last thing on the packaging that I had to mention, okay? Here they are saying it's a weekend exfoliating facial, AHA 30%, BHA 2%. Uske niche they are saying face serum oil free formula. I mean, if it's a facial, you're supposed to wash it off, then how is it a face serum? A serum is something you apply before moisturizer. It's supposed to be kept on your skin and not washed off. It's supposed to be like a moisturizer, intense moisturizing agent. A peeling solution, a facial, is supposed to be washed off. So literally in your packaging, you're contradicting your own statements. So make up your mind, Minimalist. What do you want to promote? Like, come on, let me know. Okay, now that we've already spoken about a lot of things that irked me in their packaging, let's talk about certain things that are good. They do mention all of their ingredients on the packaging and on the product itself, which is great. And they have an emphasis on the word clean. And when I went on their website as well, they are just advocating clean skincare because they are saying that they are having 6 clean beauty promises. That is no fragrance, no silicones, no parabens, no essential oils, no dyes and no sulfates. That you're promoting clean skincare, great, good for you. I like that. I like that they are transparent about things. Many skincare companies in India still are not transparent about things, so we will not shade them for that. Let's move on. Okay, so now talking about prices, the Be Minimalist peeling solution is costing you about 700 rupees and this is going to last you about 6 months from the time you open this bottle. If you look at this symbol, I'm going to put it up here. Looking at that symbol, it's very important, especially in skincare and exfoliants, that from the time you open the product, you can only use it for 6 months, then it will go bad. So this can only be used for 6 months, whereas the ordinary is priced about $12, so it's about 900 rupees. Of course, not easily available in India. You can order it on Cult Beauty or on Instagram pages. I will leave some Instagram pages for you all in the description if you all want to refer. So of course they will cost you a little more, but this can be used for about 12 months from the time you open this. So now that we've spoken about prices and packaging, let's dive into the actual patch test and demo of this product. Alright, I'm opening this box for the first time and I'm gonna do like a patch test before I of course apply this. So today I'm doing the patch test. It is, I think, the 4th of October today. So we will wait 48 hours, like 6th or 7th. I will, like, if nothing happens to me at all with the patch test, then 6th or 7th we can go ahead and apply this all over our face and see what it does. But yeah, this is the product. Looks very, very similar to the ordinary one. And this is the first time I'm opening it also in front of y'all. Matlab, do you want me to show y'all what the ordinary, the one is next to me only? This is red in color. This is like blood red in color. Like, this is the color difference in the acids. It's dripping on my reflector right now. This is like red and this is
like an orange. Okay, taking an entire pipette and I'm just going to put it on my finger. There is a fragrance to it. It's like, I mean, it's not that strong. I don't know what it smells like. I'm just applying it over here in this area to see like if there's anything happening. And I'll apply a little bit over here on my jaw because my jaw is the region that I get like a lot of like texture. So I'll just apply a little bit on my jaw. Okay, so the time right now is 2:07. Let's wait for exactly 10 minutes. It's a 10 minute exfoliating facial. So we will wait till exactly 2:17, wash this off and see what happens. It's not giving me any tingling as of now. The ordinary one does tingle initially when you apply it. There's like a tingling sensation. This has absolutely no sensation whatsoever. Alright guys, it's been 10 minutes. It's 2:16 right now. I'm going to quickly wash this off and come. Abhi tak kuch nahi hua hai. Bilkul bhi tingle wingle kuch nahi ho raha hai. Feel hi nahi ho raha hai ki kuch hai. I don't know, asar bhi kar raha hai ki nahi. But I will wash it off and see kuch reaction hota hai ki nahi. Alright, so first try is successful. Kuch bhi nahi hua hai bilkul. No irritation whatsoever. No itching whatsoever. It is what? 4th of October, like I said. Abhi 24 to 48 hours the possibility hai ki it could react with my skin. Actually, my skin is pretty resilient to acids and stuff because I use a lot of chemical exfoliants in my skincare routine. But just in general, to be on the safer side, if any new skincare you're using, you should do a patch test. So I've done mine. Let's wait for 24 to 48 hours. Kuch nahi hua, the next time you will see me trying the product on my face.
You guys, it's like 20 minutes later since I sat in the room and filmed that. Look at this. Can you see this? It's turning red. I used that thing and tabhi ke tabhi kuch nahi hua. Like as soon as I washed it, nothing happened. But it's turning red. This area on my jaw. Like, can you see? Like, should I zoom you guys in a little bit? See, it's turning red. On my neck, nothing has happened because my skin on the neck is of course different. But on my face, now that this is turning red, I'm a little scared to use it on my face. Look at this.
Alright, so you guys saw that when I did the patch test, this product did not work out for me. When I applied it over here, it was fine. Nothing really happened to my skin over here. But then my neck is not having that sensitive skin as much as my face. When I woke up the next morning after I showed the video to y'all, it was still slightly red. So I applied aloe vera gel on it. But after the redness calmed down, also my skin was itching in that area for the entire day. It did calm down in 24 hours. But then that was an indication that this product is not agreeing to my skin. And so I was still contemplating that I should use it on my skin because I want to review it for you guys. But then I went to my dermatologist the next day and she was like, if you do that, you're just going to wreck your skin's barrier for a long time. Patch test is done for that very reason, that we patch test and see if it's working for our skin and only then use it further. So I'm so glad that I did a patch test and I did not apply it to my skin straight away. This is a literal indication to all of y'all that please, please, please do a patch test, especially when there are actives in your skincare ingredients. Not everything will agree with everyone, especially me being me who uses chemical exfoliants literally on a daily basis. There's an active ingredient in all of my skincare products. And then on a monthly basis, I do use the ordinary peeling solution as well, which is super, super potent and very strong. And that suits me very, very well. It has never really given me a chemical burn or anything of that sort, or any redness, any irritation. I had done a patch test for that as well. After trying that, I did want to give y'all a solid conclusion. I didn't want to leave y'all hanging that, okay, it irritated me, but y'all can try it if y'all want. And then I decided that maybe I should go down to the ingredient list and do like a side-by-side analysis of what is in the ordinary and what is in the minimalist peeling solution. And I literally did a comparison. I have it right here in my notebook written down. And I did like a side-by-side differentiate between all of the ingredients of the ordinary as well as the minimalist and saw what is in what. So overall, the conclusion that I have come down to is that the ordinary peeling solution does have a lot more stabilizers. It has a lot more exfoliants than the minimalist peeling solution. What I've realized after all the research that I do for every one of my Skin Talk with Sarah videos is that ingredients is not everything. Formulations also matter. You need to have stable formulation of every single ingredient for them to interact well and be stable in their product. So this makes me realize that maybe the formulation of the minimalist peeling solution is not that stable, because they don't have a lot of stabilizers going on. When I compared their ingredient list, there weren't any irritants, skin irritants in both of them. Like in general, there's only one skin irritant, that is phenoxyethanol in the Be Minimalist peeling solution. And that is also, I don't know how much percentage they have used, but up to 1% is fine in skincare products. So that also I will give it to them, that it might be fine. It might be a mild irritant, but then again, there must be phenoxyethanol in other skincare products. I just feel in general, formulation wise, Ordinary has a much more stable and potent formulation as compared to the Be Minimalist formulation. It's not that stable. So will I really call it a dupe? No, not at all. They are not dupes of each other. Even though their ingredient list is very, very similar to each other, they are still not dupes. And even personal performance wise, the Ordinary peeling solution does agree with my skin, and the Minimalist peeling solution does not agree with my skin. And with that, we'll close out today's video. This was my side-by-side comparison of the Ordinary and the Minimalist peeling solution, and everything I think about the brand and that particular product. This was my personal experience. Of course, if you all have had a different experience with the product, let me know in the comments. It's still a fairly new brand, so I'm sure there is a lot more product development that will happen in the future. So let's see if there's any other product in the future that they come out with which is super original and makes me want to try it. Alright, so if you like this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And for today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Devanshi Gudwani. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, then all you have to do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, stay home, stay safe, and I love you. Mwah.